Hi, I'm John Wilson, and I'm very particular about the lines I use for freshwater fishing. I actually use several different types of monofilament line, and I guess the ratio between monofilament braid is probably 70% in favour of mono and 30% braid. So let's have a look at mono first. Now, the choice of Rovex monofilament fishing lines from Masterline Walker is not only exciting, it's very beneficial to my fishing. For instance, in certain situations, like when I'm fishing for spooky fish, I like a clear line with low memory, such as Rovex Aureus Copper. It's got a nice level of stretch with it too. Whereas for situations that demand a camouflage line, then Nitrium really fits the bill. It's soft and supple, it's got a low diameter, and it knots up well too. There are dedicated float and feeder lines too, and a serious carp line, which is low memory and is extremely limp. Casts well too. And for difficult, demanding situations, such as fishing through tough weed and over rocks, etc., then Rovex 10X formula is my top choice. This low memory, low visibility and very thin diameter line is super tough, and it's actually 10 times more abrasion resistant than other monofilament lines. It knots really well too, so let's show you a couple of my favourite knots. Firstly, here's the Marcia knot, which is great for tying hooks and swivels directly to your reel line. You'll notice that I've gone twice through the eye of the hook or the swivel, and then I'm going around 6 times around the line, which has now formed two loops. So I push the tag end through both of those loops, pull it up tight. At this point it's wise to get a little saliva, just put it on the knot and pull hard on the tag end whilst you're ribbing the knot up the coils closely with your fingernails. Now that is excellent. All we need to do now is trim the end, but never trim it too close. Just there. And that's the knot. That's never let me down. I've caught some huge fish in India, in Britain and all over the world with this knot, because when it gets under strain, see what it does? It stretches. It doesn't constrict. Now for joining two lengths of line together to make a fixed paternoster using the four-turn water knot. Now I'm going to start by trimming off about 14-15 inches from the end of the reel line. And let's say I want the hook link, say, 16-18 inches long. I then hold the end of the length that I've cut off against the end of the reel line, come around in a coil like that and go 1, 2, 3, 4 times through the loop, and then you simply slowly pull those together. This is such an easy knot to try tie, and it's such a strong junction. We'll just trim the end off, and there's the junction, one of the strongest knots you can have for a fixed paternoster. The long one is for the hook, and the short one is for the lead or the shots, the bomb or the shots. But you could have it, this one could be for the bomb and that one could be for the hook. That's why it's such a versatile knot. Now for braids. And while I do occasionally use low diameter, non-stretch braid for species like bream, particularly when leisuring at distance for maximum line pickup, much of my lure and bait fishing for predators and salmonoids is much better achieved using braid, for pike and salmon in particular. For both I use Rovex Airstrike braid, which in 30-pound test is the diameter of just 8-pound mono. It's zero stretch and has a round profile which stops it from bedding in between the coils. Now this is most important. Rovex Turgo, which is Dyneema blended, is also excellent, with a high strength to diameter ratio and low stretch. Now let me show you my favourite knot for tying on hooks and swivels when using braid. I call this my clinch and six turn uni knot, and start by putting the braid once through the eye of the hook or the swivel, but then coming inside to form a clinch like that, and then The tag end goes around in a loop, and I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times around both lines. Look how that forms a really nice, neat barrel knot, which then slides down, up, tight against the hook of the swivel. And then you just trim the end off.